champion to the online broadcast network, AfterBuzz TV. Over 20 million weekly downloads in over 150 countries and your number one source for after-show entertainment. TV, the destination for TV superfans, producing aftershows for over 300 of your favorite TV shows, interviewing celebrities and showrunners, and bringing you behind-the-scenes exclusives. All thanks to E! Entertainment's Maria Menounos, producer Kevin Undergaro, and internet leader Akamai. Now, let the buzz begin!
Oh, I turned my phone on.
Hello! Happyland after show.
I bet people are wondering who's this man in the studio.
Who's this man? We've got Shane Harper in the studio.
Woo!
Ladies, calm down. I'm talking to fans, not you two. You two. No need to be calm.
I can't.
Who are you two? We got Kylie Hodges.
Hi.
And we got Vivian Adobe.
Hello.
And of course, I'm your host, Yael Tygiel. We're talking about repeat infractions, the latest episode of Happyland.
Yeah, we are.
No.
Yikes.
Yeah.
Yikes.
It was a crazy episode. Things continue to evolve on the show.
Mm-hmm.
Let's jump into the first date. The first real date between Lucy and Noah.
Oof.
Which
turns into the double date.
Double date. And I don't know if any of you were online last night tweeting, but the fans and I have a real big question.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Once Lucy and Noah join Harper and Ian,
yeah,
and then they leave,
yeah,
to go to Ricky 360,
right?
What happened to the wings?
Oh no, the wings disappeared.
Oh, yes. Oh. So we're sitting there. All the fans are like, "Wait, they just picked up fresh wings.
Oh,
like
no.
They just got them,
and they all left."
Food. Oh right, we did. That nice little platter. It was a nice spread.
Yeah.
And then we just booked it, like, because Ricky 360 is worth it. You leave your wings for Ricky 360.
No, you eat before you start drinking.
No, it's true.
Yeah,
it's true. Maybe they just wanted to get like buzzed quicker, you know, or something. Maybe they were just like, well, we're leaving the food. We're not even gonna deal with it.
I had a granola bar on the way.
Because they're really ready to party, right? I mean, they're about to go rip it up, you know?
Well, the fans, they'd be upset if I didn't ask.
Yeah.
Because at the end of the episode, I was like, man, wings would be so good.
Can I tell
right
you something,
now?
Too? A great little story from shooting that scene in particular. Those wings were delicious. I ate so many of those wings while we were shooting. Like, they were so good. And, anyways.
So then why did you not get
fresh? Why didn't you bring
us
any?
That's the story.
Yeah,
why didn't you bring us any? We're hungry.
I'm sorry. I know. I messed up. But they were so good. They were like they were spicy, but not too spicy. And they were kind of sweet.
Are you a spicy kind of guy?
I do. I like hot sauce all over everything.
Oh, I thought you were more of a mild.
Everything. I don't like it too. I don't like it too spicy, but I like it. You know.
What are your thoughts on the sriracha plant that was closed down for a little while? Were you upset about that? Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow. Oh. Well, they're back in business. So
yeah. Well,
I bet you're happy.
Well, but the thing that made me nervous, like hearing that, was it's like the chemicals, the fumes from the plant are like making people upset, and I'm I'm eating this every day.
Yeah.
That's the thing that kind of made me a little bit trepidatious about going back for it.
Sure.
But I love it on my pizza. It works so good. Have you ever tried it?
I'm not a spicy person.
Oh, okay. If you do like,
I'm sorry.
I thought you were on my team.
You're on this side.
Whenever you need someone on your team, just look forward.
I'll just look your way. Okay. Yeah.
All right.
Off to a good start, guys. Yeah. 4 minutes in.
Wings. Really? It's important.
No, it is. These are the important things.
It was an important thing. So they start doing Ricky 360, which, I'm going to be honest, for those who've been to theme parks and are over 21, that is one of the most fun things to do is to drink in theme parks.
Oh, yeah.
It's true.
Have you ever just walk through a theme park and just, like, instead of, like, looking at the kids enjoying themselves, just, like, glanced up at the parents? There's, like...
Yeah,
you know, they're all there with like, you know, a couple beers in hand or whatever.
No, because I'm busy. I'm busy enjoying myself.
It's right. So true though. The best way to do Schmizneyland is once it gets hot around, because that's
what we call it here.
Yeah.
Around like noon, once it gets hot and your feet are kind of tired, don't try and push through it because you'll be cranky. Stop at a bar and drink for an hour.
Over in California Adventures.
Yes.
Can you?
Yes.
Yeah, but you can. Can you can't
purchase.
Well, you can get a drink, but you can't take it on the ride.
No,
that's not the way to happen.
That'd be so funny though. Like someone just like a pina colada, like on you know, going down one of the rides.
That would be perfect for a Ferris wheel though.
It would be. Any other Schmizneyland though. Anything can happen to Schmizneyland.
Yeah. Dreams should be able to come true in any sense. And if it's my wish to be able to walk with a drink in Schmizneyland, I would hope that could be
like Vegas. They don't have open containers.
It's got to be a real edgy like park that allows that, because that would it would just get cray.
All right, here's a new concept for anyone in an investor in Las Vegas: open an open intoxicant.
It already sounds bad. Right away, it sounds like.
I mean, they have roller coasters in Vegas, and I think most people who go on them are.
It's true.
They're gonna need good lawyers for sure.
Yeah. No, your ticket says on the back we are not responsible for.
Yeah, right, for anything that happens. Right.
Perfect.
So
good concept.
Ricky 360 is a thing that happens at this park, and I've been complaining since the show started that I want to know what is the story that involves a raccoon, a witch, a princess, and a prince named Prince Valor, and now we hear that there's a land. There are different lands in this story.
And evil Hagula.
There's Hagula as well.
Oh, yeah.
Is she not a witch? She's just a hag?
No, Hagula's definitely a witch.
Okay.
I think there needs to be like a comic strip or something with these characters. I'm telling you, it'd be great.
Yeah. I just want to understand the plot.
Me too.
Didn't Camille tell us that somebody told somebody?
Yeah, apparently Ryan, who plays Theodore, knows everything.
He does. So he would be the person to ask.
He's the person.
He's been on the show.
Not yet.
Mm-mm.
Yeah, you need to have words with him.
I'll talk to your
brother.
I'll get on top of it.
Just pass the information so that he knows. He has to come to AfterBuzz, and he has to let us know
what's
going on with the characters.
Yeah.
He does know everything. Yeah, because I don't know what the backstory is for all those characters. Right. Who knows?
Well,
I think
you
have to use your imagination.
Did you ever ask them? Or were they I didn't know.
I think it's part of the mystery of it all.
Oh.
I mean, there's some stories tossed around about how those characters interact, but it wasn't exactly PG.
It was like,
you know, it's like in Happyland. Yeah, in true Happyland form.
Story.
That's kind of how it was.
Well, I mean, I feel like it's like going to Schmizneyland and being in like Toontown and being like, oh, this doesn't have to make sense. I don't really care what's going on here. But there's a reason everything's there.
There is.
There's a story.
I'm sure, and you should get Ben, the creator, in here, because he would be able to go for days and just...
Would he tell us?
Oh,
other than
not.
Would he be able to?
Oh, no, he would be able to.
Yeah.
Him actually telling you is a different story. I'm not sure.
All right.
Yeah.
Well, luckily, while everyone is drinking in the park... Will and Theo are dealing with other things.
This is so funny.
I love this.
Oh, it's the best.
It's the best bromance.
Who dies in a theme park?
Well, that's the thing, is it happens all the time. I'm going to tell you guys something right now. Because I had a conversation with someone that maybe this is false information. I don't know. I might be, but what I'm saying, what I'm about to tell you, I don't know if it's actually true. But someone was saying that they like were friends with the stewardess, and you know, that works on like, you know, obviously on the plane
They're called flight attendants.
Are you sure?
Yael must be moonlighting as a flight attendant. That's why it's so touchy.
And that apparently like people do pass away like on planes and things like that, but they don't tell, like it's all under wraps. Like if someone dies on an airplane, no one knows. Have you ever been on an airplane where you like someone because it's because they land
fits.
And well no like they're sleeping, right? I've heard this story, and they just take them out back, and they like people, because they're not gonna like, that would be like hysterical if
right
you know
course.
So
but
I think the same
being
goes
next to that person.
It's
yeah.
But the analogy goes to you know, towards the idea that if you're at a theme park and someone dies, which it has to happen so many times a year, no one knows. It's just secretive, right? Because have you ever thought about it? Like, of course someone's going to die in a theme park.
No, I've never thought
that's something I thought about.
No,
never.
Of course. Okay,
once,
when this happened, when I read this episode, it all made sense to me, because you're so many, like, there's millions of people you know, like going to these theme parks every year, and like it's sad, but and it's not in tragic like death on a roller coaster because that gets reported, but like someone like dies of old age or something like. Do you know what I mean?
I mean, if you're gonna die, being in the happiest place
on earth is right. I know this is getting morbid, but if we're gonna turn it around, it really is a nice way to go.
Yeah, right. Yeah, like a nice ice cream cone right before you're done.
You don't want to shatter all the hopes.
You're going too far.
Yeah,
I'm sorry. I'm so ruining it right now. All these poor kids are just like so distraught.
This is juicy. Twitter's probably blowing up right
now. It is real. That storyline with them trying to figure it out and the guy like, you know, keeling over in the bush. Like, it's so funny. I was cracking up.
I saw a tweet that the actor who played the dead body could not keep his eyes closed. Do you know anything about this?
No, I wasn't there when they were shooting it, but I think Ryan said that.
Maybe. I'm not going to say who said it, but I saw that tweet.
I think it's Ryan. Yeah, it was Ryan. I believe him.
Yeah.
I believe him. I mean, it would be hard, though, because he had to, like, roll into the bushes, and the guys, they're, like, moving him around all the time. Right. I mean, that would be kind of hard to stay in dead character.
Well, don't some dead bodies, like, sometimes they're
too far. You're just going way too far.
No,
I thought you were
going to
say, don't they still, like, twitch and stuff? It's like, no.
Like, if you roll it, like, sometimes the eye just kind of, like, rolls open.
Well, right. No? In, like, a dramatic, like, say it's a dramatic Western or something, and someone dies, they always, like,
close their eyes.
So, yeah, I guess this is going, we should change the subject.
Okay.
This is just bad. It's going deeper and deeper, and it's
a fascinating subject.
And he knows a lot about it.
You do.
No, because I just had this conversation, though, like, last week with someone, and we were talking about this actually happening, and it makes sense. Yeah.
Well, I would be happy to continue this conversation on the SVU after show.
Yeah, sure.
Where it's relevant. Yeah. Noah reveals a little bit about himself during this date. I don't want to call it a date, because that's not at all how it turned out.
Yeah.
This outing.
But he reveals that he also has a single mom, and that he's the first one to go to college. And, like, he and Lucy have a lot in common.
Yeah.
And I know that the shippers are probably really upset.
The shippers.
Because the shippers are all about Ian and Lucy.
No, they really want us not to be related. They really do.
I am going to say it. I don't think they are.
Really?
Yeah. Whoa! Crazy twist.
Ooh,
the incest is not real incest.
It's just a theory.
Wow.
I have nothing to base that on.
No.
I just
except for your heart.
My heart, yeah.
Your heart.
I mean, we haven't seen a birth certificate.
We haven't seen DNA tests.
No, there's no hardcore evidence. This is it's hearsay right now.
I don't see any similarities in you two.
Yeah.
So.
You guys don't look alike, talk alike.
You make a cute couple, so maybe it's true. Maybe they're not.
It could be. But as of right now, though, I mean, Noah seems like a great guy, right? I mean, are you guys totally sold on Noah?
Totally for Noah.
Uh-oh, what does that mean?
No, I'm just asking.
That makes me think we shouldn't be sold
on
Noah.
I'm just asking.
Interesting.
Next couple episodes are interesting.
Okay. Oh. That so much was just said right there.
Say it again.
Gets really interesting.
I
say it again.
Wait, it gets what? Interesting?
What's that word? Okay. Just want to make sure.
Noah just seems like a really nice, genuine dude. However, I said this last week, very ballsy of him to ask out Lucy while she was talking to Will.
Mm-hmm.
Like, as a man, would you ever go up to a girl when she was talking to another guy and ask her out right there in front of the
other
dude?
When it's just the three of you? No, that's so weird.
Right.
He is really weird.
But he's really sweet. Like, he's like a puppy. I just want to be his friend.
Am I supposed to think he's weird?
No, I think you're supposed to think he's a puppy.
No, I think you're supposed to love him.
Yeah.
I love him.
I'm paranoid.
I still love you, though.
Thank you.
Still love, but he has another part of my heart.
Right here.
Calm down.
Actually, right here. My heart's right here. just about the wrong side. Sorry. They're cute. They're cute. But, it was a little bit. A little disrespectful, cutting in on Will like that.
Yeah.
He has first dibs because he's like a longtime friend.
And he was about to reveal.
I know.
His love.
Yeah.
He looks so upset.
He was so. That was a great scene. Just hard on the sleeve. He was like. Just, it was just a disaster.
For those who aren't watching, you missed the most adorable faces. So please tune in on YouTube. Yeah, to watch this. Because there are people just listening on iTunes.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Speaking of iTunes, yeah, I'm going to do it right now.
What's going on? Oh.
Speaking of iTunes.
I don't know where this is going.
You can look right there.
Yeah. Oh, right there?
Yeah, look right there.
Yeah, smile.
Yeah, keep it on him while I talk. So speaking of iTunes, guys... I can't even focus.
Here, I'll take over for you, because then everybody can look at Shane. Speaking of iTunes, please subscribe. If you love this show, rate us 5 stars. If you think we have some work to do, give us 4. Comment on YouTube. Chat with us on Twitter about the show. We love interacting with the fans, and thank you so much.
Thanks, Kylie.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah. I say that usually.
I second that.
That's great. And we're endorsed by Shane.
I love it.
I want to talk about Lucy and Harper and the blow up that goes on between them, because Harper goes to flirt with some guy for free booze.
Yeah, weird, right?
Yeah.
I mean, God, she's all over the place.
No, well, yeah,
she was 18 once.
No, I know.
But she's like flirting with this guy for the free booze, but her flirt is, look who I'm with.
Yeah.
That is the worst flirt I've ever... And I've seen some terrible flirting that I've done. So that is the... Even I wouldn't do that.
Right.
Would you buy that?
It was a weird...
If a girl came up and did that to you?
And
if you were like 21.
I'm with that other guy. I don't know. Maybe it was to make him jealous because he's not like... I don't know. But then why would he... Like, oh, let me buy you a drink.
Right.
You know, like, I don't know. Maybe that's the deal. But he asked, right? Did he initiate that? I think he...
why don't you get us some drinks with your ID? And then he responded, like, only if you drink it with me. And she's like, no, I'm with that guy.
Oh, right. Harper, I think she thinks she's all that. Like, she can just get away with it.
I interpreted that as, like, almost a threat. Like, we got President's daddy over here. You better give me whatever I want, or I'll tell him you're going to steal the statue.
That's a nice...
What year are
you? I don't know. This is the 40s.
Why don't you tell him I'm
going to make you a star.
That's a nice hypothesis.
Thank you.
All right, I'll take it.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. Well, then this guy reveals that Ian was hanging out with Lucy.
Oh.
And then Harper, okay, so I got into a discussion with someone on Twitter last night, because Harper then gets all upset about them making out, about Lucy and Ian making out. And I'm like, Harper, remember that time you cheated on your boyfriend?
Double standard.
Well, Lucy calls her out on that.
Eventually.
Well, it's Harper's world. She doesn't really care as long as she gets all the boys.
Oh, yeah. Harper's
that's a
world.
Great, that's a great point. She needs her own spinoff called Harper's World, because she is that narcissistic, I think.
I think, yeah, if there was a spinoff of Harper's World, it would just be like 30 minutes of watching her curl her hair.
Right,
because she has so much hair.
Yeah. And then, like, pick out which guy she wants to make out with that day. Like, just pictures on her mirror.
Putting on her outfits.
Yeah.
I would watch that show.
Yeah, I would too.
Only if you made a cameo.
Harper's
though.
World is on. Leave it on.
Harper's World. It kind of sounds like an MTV show too, because it's like...
It makes me think of the cartoon Bobby's World.
Yes.
Anyone?
Okay. You mean Howie Mandel does Thursday? All the voices?
Yeah. So Howie Mandel would do the voice of Harper.
But it would still be Kat.
It would be a cartoon.
That's really uncomfortable.
Looking like Katherine McNamara, but it would be Howie Mandel.
I imagine Kat with the voice of Howie Mandel.
Yeah, that's really uncomfortable.
It's a strange spot. I bet a lot of people would watch.
Yeah.
That would be on Adult Swim.
Hey, I was just going to say, that's definitely on Adult Swim.
Guys, I've just pitched like 3 shows right now. I'm going to be rolling in the dough.
You are on a roll tonight.
We should talk about this show.
Yeah, that's smart.
Let's talk about
it. Makes
this
sense.
Show rocks.
Yeah. I mean, it's inspired so many spin-offs.
Yeah, it totally does.
Well, so they're Lucy and Harper's blow up happens as the statue of Ricky Raccoon is being stolen, and Harper's holding the crowbar.
Yeah, right.
And I don't understand.
She's like, huh? She's just like, giant crowbar.
But what is she like? What did she do with the crowbar? Because they didn't seem to need it.
Exactly.
It was just for decoration. Just so she can feel like she's a part of the team.
No, you don't. I mean, look, there's some backstory there. Maybe she had to, like, maybe it was bolted down, you know, and she...
And Harper unbolted it.
She's the strong one.
The bolts could have been removed before we saw her, you know? She has tiny hands, so maybe she was unscrewing.
Yeah, but that's a giant... That was... It was like the wrench was that big, was it?
Or was it a crowbar?
It was a crowbar.
Yeah.
Oh, wait, no, this all makes sense. The guy, as a crowbar makes total sense because you don't actually have to be that strong to rock a crowbar because it's all about the...
Right, but what did she do with it?
Oh, she just, because it was plastered to the ground.
Yes.
And she had to... Like, you know what I mean? Maybe it was like...
That's not something I see Harper doing.
Right.
In Harper's defense, I think it would be really easy to flirt with some guys if you're like, oh me, oh my, I've got this crowbar, but I need some extra help.
Can you help me? And then the big guy comes around and he's like, I got you, babe.
Yeah, exactly.
I'll take it. That is exactly why she has a crowbar.
Thank you.
This show is so philosophical. I love it. We're just working through all of the issues. It's great.
What was the statue made of? Do you know?
Oh, yeah. It's like a...
No, not
chocolate.
No. I meant the set piece. Just eating it in between the actual. I didn't mean what the...
Are you asking what the prop piece is made of?
Yes, thank you.
Yeah, the prop is actually, like, pretty light. It was, like, some kind of, styrofoam something.
Oh.
Like, styrofoam, but a little bit more sturdy. So I don't know if it, you know, some kind of hybrid of... Styrofoam hybrid. I don't know.
Did you try stealing it yourself?
I didn't.
Does somebody have it now?
Oh. That's a great question.
Yeah.
It's probably in some warehouse in Van Nuys. covered in dust.
It's so true. I'm so sad. I know. Some of the best props just...
Are
in a warehouse in Van Nuys, and no one ever sees them again.
To those listening who are not from Southern California, go to Google Maps, search Van Nuys. You will see that it's in the
central.
V-A-N space N-U-Y-S.
Yeah.
It's in the middle of the valley of Los Angeles.
The valley.
San Fernando Valley.
Yes.
Where props go to never come back again.
Where props go to die.
Sets die.
Oh, sad. Yeah.
Again, with the morbid vibe.
We are just really
the theme is it's a strong thread right now.
I want to complain about Harper more.
Great.
People are not.
wait. Before we do, I just want to clarify that we love Kat. Katherine McNamara is an amazing actress.
Oh, she's such a peach.
And she's so sweet.
No, well, she's doing a great job.
She's doing a great
job. Harper's character. She's like annoying and like just is like she like just ruins things. But she has a sweet.
She means
deep
well.
Down.
Well,
I don't believe it.
She's like a wounded puppy, though. Like, she doesn't always realize that she's peeing on the carpet over and over.
So
she's a
true.
Wounded puppy.
No, that's
and she's very territorial.
Mm-hmm.
She is. She's very territorial. No,
but everything is hers. She's very territorial, but she thinks everything is hers.
Right.
Delusional?
Yeah. Maybe a bit delusional. and a bit narcissistic.
Yeah.
For sure. But yes, Kat's doing a great job.
She is.
Because we're talking about her.
Yeah. Now you can complain about
it.
Well, my complaint about Harper was how she doesn't listen. Because Lucy said, like, look, this was something that happened before you. Like, just trust me, I couldn't have told you.
Right.
And also, I feel like if I was Harper, I probably would have been a little confused. I found out my sort of boyfriend had made out with my sort of friend.
The guy that I'm dating right now.
Thingy.
Yeah.
my guy, whatever she called it.
It was really
funny. My guy boyfriend.
Thingy.
Person. Thingy. Yeah, right. It was like really, really awkward.
Yeah.
That's another thing. Are you guys going to DTR? Define the relationship?
What Ian's going to do. He's a hot mess. No, the next... I'm not going to give away any spoilers. I mean, because the next... Oh, my gosh. We're already at episode 5.
Yeah.
I can't...
Yeah.
It's so weird. Like, I thought it was episode 4, because in my heart, I didn't want it to be 5 already. So I was like, episode 4. I literally thought it was, because it's going by so quick. But the next few episodes, so much happens in the last few episodes. It's insane.
Oh.
I mean, everything... there's this huge readjustment. Everything... Like, there's another huge... Like, the way that second episode... Or the end of the pilot and then the second episode and kind of the whole thing getting turned upside down, it kind of flip-flops again with a bunch of new information, and it kind of... Something that would propel us into...
That they're not related.
The future.
No, I didn't
say that.
I'm going to ask real quick, because I know the fans really want to know.
Yeah.
Are we going to see more James Chandler?
This fan, right?
I'm getting some. My Twitter feed is just blowing up.
They want to know.
Oh yeah, James.
I want to know.
Yeah. No, James is. Yes, he's coming back.
He better be.
Yeah. Ooh.
Or Yael will be upset.
Yeah.
Brady. Swing by anytime.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
What were we talking about?
Papa Chandler.
I have a question about Ian.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
What can you tell us about what he did in New York that was so awful?
Yes.
That broke Daddy Chandler's heart.
And when did we find out?
Oh, yeah. Man. It's so good.
We do find out.
It is so juicy.
Can you tell us a little bit?
You're a baby daddy, aren't you?
I can't tell you anything because I got the backstory because I needed it to play the character, obviously. Uh-huh. But it's like it's very. When Ben told me, I was just like. I had no idea that was it. I thought it was some little thing, but it's like a big thing. I don't think we find out though, and
We don't find out this season.
We need a season two. We need some more episodes.
Can you give us a little hint though? Something.
I can't because
Just something. Yeah. Come on. Eye contact.
Because it's such a. I'm just gonna
blink twice if it's murder.
he killed someone.
I'll ask this. I'm sure fans have speculated. Has anyone guessed it yet? Has it been?
Oh, their reason for coming back,
What he did in New York.
No, no one's gotten it.
Wow. Okay.
No. Must be not done. To my understand. No, not to my knowledge. Know. Yeah.
So are you and then Ben the only people that know what he did in New York? Like the
I'm
other
sure
actors don't.
Theo knows.
Theo knows. It was so funny because while we were shooting, like Ben was very much about. Just giving you the information your character knows so that you're not playing stuff you shouldn't be playing, you know, in scenes.
Yeah.
And which I really love. And but it was so annoying because the whole, like, Theo knows everything. And I was like, so Ryan, what's, like, in between scenes, be like, so what, John, what really happened? You know, like, in between they're setting up for a new shot. And he's like, I'm not going to tell you. I'm just like, please. he didn't give any secrets away.
I imagine during lunch, like, he had to sit away from everyone because everyone was like, tell me. And he was like, I can't talk to anyone.
Yeah, he's like the mob boss of the
Happyland
world. Yeah, yeah.
Is that why he always wears a suit?
Yeah, with a cool suit. I was like...
That totally is mafia look.
Yeah.
It is.
Yeah.
With that coiffed hair and that...
Definitely.
Yeah. Coiffed.
And that's why the fans love him.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yael also loves him. Do you love more, the dad or Theodore?
Let's
be honest.
That's silly that I even asked.
You know the answer. I'm all about the DILFs. All of them.
True. Yeah. Yael plus DILFs equals.
Oh man.
Yeah. Equals Happyland.
It's a party over here at AfterBuzz.
Always.
Yeah.
Always.
It is always a party here. I want to talk about Kiki in the Happy Dorm.
Kiki, we got it.
So Lucy, after Noah can't handle Harper, he can't handle Ian, he can't handle the partying, because Noah's kind of a square.
Don't pick on Noah.
He's a square.
He's a cute square.
That said,
he's a cute square.
He is an adorable square.
He's an adorable square.
It's the opposite of on Finding Carter, which we did together here. Mm-hmm. I was always like, no, like, this is a good child. This is a good kid. He's responsible.
Yeah.
And here I'm like, no, he's a square.
Yael's not on Team Good Kid anymore.
Not anymore.
It's okay. That's why I'm here.
Yeah. She's got the
we
good
got
kid.
Some balance.
You got the bad boys.
Yeah.
I got the DILFs. Yeah.
That word, doesn't it just make
it
you feel
me
uncomfortable?
Yeah, me too. Yeah, the MILF and the DILF thing, that should have never gotten coined. Like, I remember, like, it's the first time, like, I figured out what that was, and I don't know how old I was or whatever, when it first got, when did that come about?
When American Pie came out, the first one.
Okay, great.
Oh,
well, then I don't know. I was just very I was like, what? What is this? It's my, anyways. Still makes me uncomfortable.
I'm sorry.
No, it's okay.
It makes me very comfortable.
It makes me very comfortable.
It's not what I said. What were we talking about?
What are your thoughts with Square Noah?
Oh, Square Noah. I like that Lucy finally goes to him at the end. I like that after he's been chasing her and failing, she finally realizes that, like, this is good for her. And she has a nice conversation with her mom. Mm-hmm. And then we meet Kiki.
I hope Kiki comes back
and doesn't ever say anything.
Yeah, just goes.
Yeah.
Just makes faces.
She's great.
I want to see Kiki walking through Happyland with a sheet wrapped around her. That's the only thing she ever wears in the show is
Noah's
sheet. Or Noah's sheet.
Noah's sheet, right.
Yeah.
I kind of want to see Kiki and Dave. come back together. Dirty Dave and Kiki walking around through Happyland looking Dirty for Dave. Jobs.
That'd be great.
What's it like working with Josh Groban?
Kiki and Dave. Dave and Kiki. Yeah. Josh is great. I was pretty excited to get to meet him and work with him. He's so good. I mean, he's obviously an amazing singer and, you know, musician and writer and all those things. But he's a great, great actor, obviously. And I loved him in Crazy Stupid Love and, you know, all that stuff. I just think he's so talented. So,
Does he inspire you at all? Because we know that you sing as well, and he has very inspirational music in general.
Yeah, totally. No, it is, because he's a really accomplished musician and a respected actor. He really is. I mean, he gets great roles, and it's cool to see that be done, simultaneously. To do those two things takes a lot of work and a lot of balance, and I think he's doing really well, and it's inspiring because, you know, means that I can do it. I can try and do it, because it is tough sometimes. But he does it so well and with a lot of poise. So
yeah.
And he's really funny.
Isn't he great? He's so funny.
Are we going to continue to see him through the rest of the season?
How many episodes has he been in so far? Three?
Yeah.
Three? That might be. I'm not sure. That could be it. I can't recall. I'm sorry. Did anyone tell you our schedule for this?
Like, you guys shot
everything together. Yeah, we shot all of it. It's like block shooting in, like, pulling long days. Mm-hmm. Like, we didn't even know. So you do a couple episodes at a time, right? So, like, the sides, you know, you get your like, dailies. They're, like, this big. They're the sides. And, like, flipping through them. And it's always changing episodes. You're like, where am I right now in the show? It was a mess. But I'm not sure. I think he might be wrapped up, but I'm not sure.
Have you ever watched an episode and been, like, thoroughly surprised by what you saw? Because you just, like you said, you were so confused while shooting. Yeah. You're like, oh, this is...
You were so confused. I promise. I was very busy. Professional. Trying, yeah, right. I was... No, it's true, though, actually, because you do kind of hone in on your storyline, because that's obviously the one that's most important for you as the performer. And it is interesting getting to really watch it and, like, see all the other stuff that I wasn't on set to watch get shot and, you know, stuff like that. It's really exciting. I love the show. I'm so excited about it. Yeah, it's great.
The fans also love the show.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I want to switch gears and talk about Elena, who has graduated from her training for VIP tour guys.
Yeah. So proud of her.
She was really proud. She was super excited until she met two other ladies who also graduated, and they were like, let's go drinking. And it turns out that they're 22 and a half.
Feeling 22.
Yeah.
That. So bad for Elena. I mean, I have ripped on her a lot, and with good reason. She seemed like she's been a crappy mom before. But
what?
Like,
she's a crappy mom.
Like, it's just really sweet that she actually does care a lot about her job. And then when it's not that there's anything wrong with her doing this job, but the fact that it feels less special to other people makes her kind of feel self-conscious about being so proud of this accomplishment.
Yeah.
And it tugs at your heartstrings, because you were excited when she was excited, and then she starts to feel bad, and you're like, oh no, feel good.
Yeah.
No, the struggle is real. In that moment, for sure. Because it is really sad. Mm-hmm. Like, I mean, and that, it really got me, because she is so excited, and it feels very genuine, and you're excited for her, and then it's like, oh, like, you realize, like, she thinks she's a deadbeat. Like, and it's a bummer. I like the way it plays, though. It's really real and cool.
Yeah.
You know, because, I mean, some people do feel like that, and they get stuck in a rut. But she, you know, I guess she'll discover her inner, you know, positivity or whatever.
She'll end up,
at some point.
I feel like she will end up being the person in charge of the tour guides. Like,
totally.
I feel like she's going to work her way up.
Absolutely.
Whereas these other girls are just coming in, it's their summer job. It is, you know, they're just going to be there and leave, and she's going to work her way up and manage them.
Right, and who knows Happyland better than her?
Yeah, that's true.
Plus, all the 22-year-olds will be focused on you, since they were so interested in talking to you that night.
How funny was that, too, when she's like, oh, this is the guy?
This is
What's
how you
up?
Do it.
And they even turn around, she's like, oh.
Awkward.
Yeah, it's like,
it never occurred to me that Ian calls her Mrs. Velez.
Yeah,
Miss Velez. It never occurred to me, and then he said it, and I was like, oh.
It just feels so matronly.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hi, Miss Velez.
Miss Velez. I think that's his, like, way top percent upbringing, like really wealthy, like calling Mr. Mrs. You know, kind of like prim and proper. Mm-hmm. I think that's probably where that comes from. Because it is, no one. Who does
I feel
Will
like when
him?
You're a grown adult, you don't call someone's parent that. You would call them their first name.
Right.
Oh, I still say Mr. and Miss.
Really?
I was raised
Are
in
you
the
Southern?
South.
Okay, yeah.
See, that's...
Southern
yeah.
is different. That's cute.
Yeah, I was raised by foreigners as a child. We called everyone.
I was raised by
We call everyone by their first name.
You don't even call your mom.
No.
You're like, hey, Alice. I'm hungry.
We're foreigners. You think her
My
name is Alice?
I don't know your mom's name. I used mine.
Yeah.
So I was like, Alice? That doesn't really fit.
I call my mom Alice, and then she stops talking to me. So.
I call my mom by her first name sometimes. That's just to be cute. Like, she has a nickname first name. That's what I call her.
Interesting.
Well, her name's Tanya, but I call her Ton. Like, hey, Ton, you know? Like, she kind of, I don't know. It's just kind of cute.
That's cute.
I like it. I think she likes it, too. But, yeah, it's good to, it's like, hey, Ton.
I never really asked. Oh, man.
But what is your relationship with Elena? Because this is a woman that slept with your father, allegedly.
Yeah, kind of weird.
She's daddy's mistress.
Yeah. Right. And now the cute. Girl you had a crush on, totally your sister.
Yeah, I don't know. I feel like it's really uncomfortable. But he doesn't seem that uncomfortable in the conversation that they had, right?
Really?
I mean, I think he's like, oh, like he's trying to be nice.
Yeah.
He's not being a jerk.
Yeah, sure. No, he definitely seemed like he was just trying to be, like, really nice and also kind of get her away.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, true.
Like, why are you here by me? Are you looking for
He's
Lucy?
Like, actually, yeah. Yeah, I guess she was like, aren't you a little...
Young?
She said young?
Yeah.
And he was like, no.
How old is Ian?
Oh, yeah.
Is he 17, I think?
Ian's in high school?
No, aren't like 17, 18. They're okay. all, like, basically seniors? Getting out of high school, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, they're all seniors in high school, basically, I think.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because this is still summertime, right?
Yes.
Okay. Is the whole season just one summer?
Yeah.
Okay.
So I mean, in theory, yes. Those mm-hmm. those 8 episodes are the whole summer.
Gotcha.
I mean,
okay.
Unless further indicated, like, unless there's something else going on. Yeah. Which
2 years and, later.
Yeah, right.
So Noah is a college intern, and he's living
exactly.
in, like, a dorm
Exactly.
housing
well,
area.
Yeah, well, he's living in Happyland for the moment.
In the happy dorms.
Right.
Which look which, not happy.
No.
Like regular dorms.
I mean, look at
you. Like regular.
I lived there. Smells like a lot of Axe body spray and dirty
laundry. I thought you were going to say something
yeah,
different.
That's
it sounds like a lot of Axe.
Yeah.
Yep. No, I lived in a co-ed dorm in college, and it's like, you could always tell when you were near the boys' rooms, because they would use Axe as, like,
Axe
air
just doesn't
spray.
Yeah. They do. They're like,
yeah, oh, this
they, like,
whole room stinks here, Axe. Yeah. I had to, like, I would, like, yell at them. I'd be like, please stop using Axe.
Axe
Febreze, or do your laundry and shower.
No, Febreze is great, or, like, a nice cologne. I always tell.
Wow, we got a real man.
Well,
here.
I always tell younger men, like, look, guys, like, some nice deodorant. No, I do. Men. Like, my, yeah, like younger brother, or, like, cousin, or his cousins, or whatever. I'm just like, look. Skip the Axe phase. Like, just skip it. Like skip it. Like, you'll probably, like, you'll be fine without it. Like, you'll be totally fine. And yeah.
And the world will thank
you. Don't,
yeah.
Exactly. It just, everyone gets a headache. It's not, it's like, oh, everyone knows that it's Axe. It's not like, and it's just, I mean, maybe if you're, like, a long day doing, like, sports, or it's like you're a jock and you need a really quick cover up, because you don't.
You should be wearing deodorant.
Well, no, you should, exactly.
And shower. And add deodorant.
And, right. Well, Axe also gives the excuse to not shower, right?
Oh.
Like, for sure. It's like, oh, I don't need a shower.
That's horrible.
Right.
It's disgusting.
But, like, you have to shower. If you're going to put on, like, deodorant and cologne, which is, like, the adult thing to do, you have to shower. Because you can't just cover it up with, like, a nice cologne and, like, deodorant. It doesn't work that way.
Yeah.
Grown man advice with Shane Harper.
Just, like,
more
with my little mug.
Yeah. You just suddenly have a mustache.
Like,
I just imagine, like, a, you know, like a Tom Reynolds mustache.
It just jump just cuts, like, and
I'm Burt Reynolds or Tom Selleck?
No, Burt,
sorry,
yeah.
You need to pick
I
one.
I thought of Tom Selleck or Burt Reynolds.
I know.
My bad.
Both of those. Very handsome
men.
Yeah,
they both sported mustaches.
Those men are so
those
handsome.
Are
Those are dope. Those are dope.
Is Yael blushing at the idea of Tom Selleck being in the room right now?
Tom Selleck is so sick. He is rad. Yeah. That mustache, that's rad.
Yeah. I bet all these listeners are like,
who's Tom Selleck? Yeah.
Google it. Yeah, Google Tom Selleck.
Just Van Nuys, California, and Tom Selleck. Yeah, you guys have
we gave homework. You homework.
Van Nuys and Tom Selleck. Yeah. Well, what we covered today.
The last thing I want to talk about is Lucy tells Harper the big secret. I put it in quotes because that is no secret.
That was so stupid.
Yeah. Yeah. I don't think Harper's going to keep it a secret.
Mm-mm. It's Harper's role. She's not going to keep it a secret. No. She's going to use it to her advantage at some point. Yeah. It's so depressing. Why would she do that? That was her big secret to tell. And she told Harper, of all people, Harper.
No, that's a good point.
And not Will. Yeah.
Oh, not Will. Well,
yeah. You would think she would have told Will, of all people. I kind of thought she was going to tell him in the last episode. But I was gonna say that I want to guess who's the first person Harper spews to, because we know she's gonna spill the beans.
What
so
do you
I'm
think?
Just curious. I think it's either.
Oh, I totally.
Oh, go you go.
No,
I'm not sure.
Okay, here's how it's gonna go down.
Oh no.
Because after
I get nervous when you.
Sure.
All right. So what's happening?
Okay. So remember after Will frees Lucy and Harper from Happyland Jail, he was like, it was nice to talk to you too or whatever.
Right.
Because she ignores him. They're gonna finally have a talk, and and he's gonna be all like, blah, Lucy, and then Harper is gonna be like, they're not together, blah, 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 blah. They're brother and sister. Boom.
I think it's going to come out when Will finds out that Harper cheated on him.
Yeah.
Wow. This is good stuff. I still don't know how I feel. I just can't decide.
You're like, gosh, this is all great.
You need to marinate.
Yeah.
I don't know.
So, I'm right,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, how are we hot or cold?
I say a thing. I just think it's great.
Wow.
I think it's great. You're very in tune with the show.
Wow. That said so much.
Yeah. I'm just saying.
You know
what, though? You're in tune.
Thank you. The other thing that I suggested, and I really hope it happens, and if it happens, I hope it happens in season two, I think that Harper and Theodore would be adorable.
I wonder what the age gap is, though.
Who cares?
Oh, I mean, she'll be 18. He's probably...
Who cares?
Maybe old. He's 25.
I don't know if you've met me, but I don't care.
Age ain't nothing but a number.
I thought you wanted Theodore and Elena.
Yeah.
Oh, I also thought about that. That was also a good one.
Yeah, we need to find Theo some... Theo needs some action in season two, you know? Because
I mean, Harper is available.
She's always available.
That's what I'm saying. I didn't want to say it.
Even when she's not available, she's available.
I'm going to flirt with you by telling you about this other guy.
Yeah, right.
What about Lucy and Theodore?
Ooh, that makes my skin crawl.
Yeah, that's weird.
I'm sorry. They're brother and sister.
Oh, yeah, I forgot.
Keep the whole, you know, thing. You gotta keep it straight.
I got confused. I just think they're both good-looking people, so.
That's true.
Hey, wait, what about...
Oh. Game of Thrones.
Oh, incest.
Yeah.
Guys, I don't watch Game of Thrones.
I don't watch it either.
What is wrong with
someone
you two?
Someone gets me. You know what? Here's the thing. I had to pick a show to commit to.
No, no.
And I chose a comedy over Game of Thrones.
What'd you choose?
I chose Orange is the New Black.
Okay, good choice. Yeah. Good choice.
I'm done with it. I could easily start Game of Thrones,
no,
but it's
not
a daunting
easily,
task.
You're gonna write.
No.
It's a lot.
It's
you're,
so
do
it. Much.
Really?
It's not like a 30-minute MTV show, guys.
It's worth it.
Exactly.
Which, I'm going to tell you, the reason I appreciate Happyland as a 30-minute show with only 8 episodes is that means we are getting so much story.
Yeah.
That's true.
And you don't have to sit on the edge of your seat and wait because you and get angry, because that's what I do.
right.
You get answers, and I'm so excited. And we have 3 episodes left with lots of exciting stuff coming.
Yeah.
3, that's so wild.
And then season 2, where Harper and Theodore get together, where
right.
James moves in.
This is called Harper's World. That's what Harper's World is.
Yeah. And where Kiki and Dave get together.
Yeah.
Kiki and Dave. That's like, I love that idea. I really do, because Kiki's a hoot.
Yeah.
She is.
She's a hoot and a holler.
Are we going to see more Kiki? Was that all of her?
I'm going to go ahead and say that's probably all of her in this season. But we could always... We can always reel her back in. I'm sure she'd be totally down.
Right.
You know?
Those faces, though.
Yeah.
Award-winning facial expressions, in my opinion.
Big time.
Also, yeah, also it. She looked beautiful, and all she was wearing was a sheet.
Yeah, kudos.
She can make anything flawless. Look nice.
Killing it, yeah. Girl.
KD, you really got it. Wow. She woke up like when that. When you got it, you got it. Yeah. Right.
Yeah. Did you have some fan questions?
I did. It was your Shidget fan on Twitter. I forgot
say
the number.
It again.
What's the actual? What's the handle?
Ooh, there's a
few
Shidgets. I think it's like at Shidget and then a number like 512.
We got a Shidget army happening online.
Yeah.
Don't be mad at me, person that was tweeting at me today.
Shidget army. That's a good one.
While I look up their handle, I will
one.
Ask.
This is your. This is your.
I will ask
one?
The question.
Can I
it
sneak
was
into that one?
Person.
Go for it.
Can I? I don't want it. No, because that's you guys. I don't want to mess up. Looks good though. You guys look good.
It's Shidget fan 2011.
Oh, I love them. They're great.
Yeah.
They're great.
They're very vocal on
they
Twitter.
Are.
I appreciate
very vocal.
It. Okay, so they have a few questions for
oh,
you.
Oh, no.
First of all, do you... Thank you, Steven. Steven, the booth is just full of jokes today.
Yeah.
All right, this is going to keep playing. How are you similar to your character, Ian?
Oh, I'm a... I love this background music. It's so good. I think that I'm...
It's really hard.
Yeah, seriously. I think Ian is, I think he's...
Breathe.
You know, he's... I know, it's so funny.
Time's up.
He's definitely gone through his fair share of struggles, but deep down inside, I think he's a people person.
Okay.
And I really... And I love that. Too much.
Steven,
and, I kind of consider myself a people person too, so
okay.
Maybe that's it.
That is
yeah,
fair.
People.
They also want to know if you have any new music coming out.
Yeah, my new music is done for the most part. I'm just trying to figure out when I want to release it.
Ooh.
When it's time, yeah. So it's exciting.
Are you collaborating with anybody? Is there a new sound?
Is
what can you tell us?
Is there a Shidget thing?
Is there a Shidget sound?
Wait, what are we hearing now? Is this Who Wants to Be a Millionaire?
Yes.
Wait, Stephen, am I right or am I wrong?
Yes.
All right, okay.
Yay!
That's so good.
You won $100.
Yes.
I love that show.
There it is.
It's so fun. It's the best, isn't it? That was Regis, right, in his prime?
Yeah. Regis.
And then Meredith Vieira.
Regis.
Mm-hmm. And then
he's
not
I stopped watching after Regis left.
Yeah me too.
Because it moved to daytime. Is that your final answer?
Right.
What was your answer?
New music. It's gonna sound different, for sure, but similar in that I still wrote all of it, you know, and with other writers and stuff. But no collaborations. It's still just me.
Do you have a dream collaboration?
Oh yeah. I mean, I'd probably say Chris Martin from Coldplay.
Mm, nice. Wow.
I love them.
Yeah.
He's one of my favorite songwriters. He really is.
Especially since he's single again, maybe some good breakup music.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Right.
That got real.
Yeah. Oh, I mean, have you listened to Ghost Stories, the last record?
It's very good.
Heartbreaking. It's really good.
Yeah.
It's amazing. It's probably my favorite since, like, the earlier stuff. But it's all good. Every single record, I feel like every time, is so good. I've seen them in concert a bunch.
Did you and Josh Groban get to, like, play together or jam out?
No. That would have been amazing. Just a little, like, jam some You Raise Me Up.
Yeah.
That would have been... Awesome.
Yeah. And then suddenly, like, a gospel choir comes out behind you. To How crazy would that be?
Wait, can you continue singing?
No.
This is not Josh Groban, Steven.
No,
this is
God.
Really sad animal commercial.
Guys, it's
Josh,
Sarah
I'm sorry.
But I just
over
think
this.
Of the sad puppies whenever I hear this song.
I'm Sarah McLachlan.
Yeah.
Did you guys see... He's so brilliant. Did you ever see the Kanye West tweets?
Yes!
He did.
On Jimmy Kimmel.
Oh my gosh, it's so funny.
It's very good.
Oh my gosh. I want to find a comfy pillow or something like
that. In case you guys don't know what he's talking about, Josh Groban, you know how his sound is very like inspirational music.
Epic.
And he took real tweets from Kanye West and turned them into songs.
He just sung them over like
it's
melodies.
Yeah.
And it's
Josh Groban releases his most anticipated album yet.
Yeah.
Oh, hello there. I'm Oscar and Grammy-nominated singer Josh Groban. You love Kanye West's tweets as much as I do? You are going to love my new album.
Josh Groban's The Best Tweets of Kanye West.
And we please toast to the mother...
Oh, there it is.
Oh, it's on the screen.
You know where to find... Marble comfort. Yeah. Came to have a comfort.
we need you to start doing this. Not until I get the table.
Oh,
we need,
so
we need you to start
you
making
so
an album
much.
Like that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It can be a man. You should make an album of the best of Amanda Bynes' tweets.
Oh, that'd be great.
Too far? I mean, it's been over
soon.
A year. Sorry. All right. I'll think of a new celebrity with a good Twitter account.
what about movies? Because I've been a fan of yours since God's Not Dead.
Oh, okay.
Saw that
okay,
last
great.
Year or earlier this year.
Right. Yeah. That would have been earlier.
Time moved so quickly.
Yeah, earlier this year. Yeah, yeah.
So do you have any other movies in the works?
No, Dance Off just came out, which was like the last one I did, which you can get on like VOD and stuff. It's, you know, all over the digital world. But no, nothing right. I mean, I have some stuff that I want to do that I'm kind of talking about, but no, nothing like, nothing in the works at the moment.
You've been busy with Happyland.
We have, yeah. No, this has been a huge focus this whole back half of the year, so. But hopefully next year I'll have some movies out. I love doing movies. It's really fun. So hopefully, yeah.
Okay.
Last question by your Shidget fan.
Okay.
Who are your celeb crushes?
Oh, well, I have to say my girlfriend.
I was going to say, I feel like Idjit is the answer.
Yeah, Idjit? Yeah, I'm going to go with Idjit for that one. Yeah, Idjit's my celebrity crush. Well, it's just great because I can genuinely use that. It's not a cop out.
Great answer.
Idjit's my answer. Yeah.
My other question.
It's a silly question to come from Shidget.
I mean, Shidget wanted to know.
Shidget,
deliver.
The answer is Idjit. Come on, pay
all
attention.
Right. Do you have any unique stories about the casting process for the show? Because I know Cameron and Kat were kind of in. I don't know. They had interesting stories because they were reading
stories?
For different parts.
Who did you audition for?
Oh, right. Yeah, no, I'm pretty sure my first audition was Ian. Yeah, from the start. But I was the first one cast, which is really cool.
Oh,
that's
wow.
Exciting. Yeah, I was really excited about that because I don't know, just kind of felt special. I was like, oh, this is fun, you know?
Yeah,
It was definitely cool to be a part of it from that moment. Nothing super crazy. I did bring, it was funny, I wanted to look like just right for the test, like the, you know, the last audition before they book you. And so I brought like a bunch of shirt options. And like, I think Ben, a director for the pilot, told me to, but so I'm like in the waiting room and I'm like, Ben, what do you think about this? You know, like Ben was like there and he was like, yeah, I like that shirt, put that one on. You know, it was like really funny, you know, because they were trying to help everyone kind of like, you know, when it's down to the wire like that and it's only a few people for each role, you know, Ben was being really sweet. He's trying to help everyone kind of like feel the character as much as they could. So that was kind of funny. But I think I was the only one that really took it that seriously. You know, they're like, oh, bring some options. Most people were like, nah, too cool for that. But I was like, yeah, I got it. Because coming like with my little like rolling my clothes in on the rack. You know?
And that's how you got the role.
Yeah, right, exactly. Yeah.
Dedication to the wardrobe.
Yeah. 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 It's all about
wardrobe. How much did you know about the role when you auditioned? Did you know that you'd be playing someone who is making out with his sister? Are you shimmying at me?
Please keep going.
Is this, are we about to have a shimmy contest?
This is like Honey Ball now.
I love the shimmy.
Who doesn't?
You are a dancer, so it makes sense.
I am a dancer. I'm a dancer. Yeah, I knew. I mean, I read the pilot. This music. Love The Price is Right, by the way. Even the new one. It's great.
Yeah, with Drew. Drew Carey.
Yeah, with Drew.
Yeah. I stopped watching when Bob left because
You're not loyal to these shows. You go. You leave as soon as the first person's out.
Yeah, because I'm a hipster. Duh.
Oh, got it.
I like the OG of things.
No, but Drew, solid.
Yeah.
He is. I mean, he's as good. A purveyor of The Price is Right, I love me some Price is Right. And he's good. He's good. And he looks great now.
He does.
He's very spelt.
Yeah, my gosh. He's just on there just like,
yeah, he looks like a new person. I'll also say I just stopped watching because I got a job.
Yeah, that also might be it.
So, not at home at 10 a.m. anymore.
Right.
Who's not
Are you sure everyone? Yeah. Whatever.
So you read the pilot before you went in?
Yeah, I read the pilot before I went in. So I got, I knew the whole lot, you know? But it's interesting, though, because it really, from episode, you do get so much information in each episode, so it was incredible to like, have the pilot, shoot it, and then
after it got picked up, it was like, okay, here's the whole rest of the story. And, like, you know, each time get a new script to be like, oh, this is what my character's really like. Because the interesting thing a lot of people don't realize is that process. People at home watching, they don't know that, like, you know, sometimes episodes progressively get so much more intuitive and, like, interesting because the actors are learning about their characters. That's why it's really fun for shows to go for a while because they're just learning more and more. With TV, I think it's unique because with movies, you see the whole picture. But with TV, the actor's learning it as, you know, as the audience is learning it, really, because they're seeing, you know, in succession, like, each script. And so it's really exciting. But every episode had such a big, you know, packed a wallop. So
it was definitely
Dollop interesting. That, yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Can I ask one last question?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
What does your tattoo mean on your arm?
My tattoo?
Your tattoo? Sorry, my Midwestern accent popped out.
Oh, really? Midwest?
From Wisconsin.
Oh, right, right, right. I talked about
that. Piat goal.
It means rhythm.
Rhythm.
Rhythm. Just the word. One word.
Cool. Yeah.
One like language. Madonna.
That's in Hebrew. That's very clearly Hebrew.
Were you just gonna ask
what language it was in?
Yeah.
Well, you are looking at it upside down.
Upside down.
I was just assuming.
Upside down. It definitely is.
Yael over here thinks everybody knows Hebrew.
Is that not? That's not true.
No, most people know Hebrew. Yeah. I'm with, you know.
This is very true.
I'm the 1% that doesn't know it, I guess.
Yeah.
Oops.
I mean, it's
my bad. Yep. Okay, Kylie.
It's
Well, the more you know, rhythm in Hebrew on his arm. Yeah. Moving on.
Okay.
Sorry, it's such a sore subject. I wanted the tattoo to be a fun topic.
Yeah. Other tattoos?
Ooh. Not yet.
I feel like we talked about this.
We did.
We did.
On our big press day, we did. I'm actually stopping by our tattoo shop tomorrow because I'm going with my sister because she's getting some new work, and then my brother and I are stopping in to see the guy that, because we have the same tattoo artist. Like I got this at the same time as my brother. It's like a back to back session because he wanted one. And I was like, oh, okay, let's just go together. And I can just do a little family bonding, you know? Just get needles jabbed into you over and over and over again.
Some people have family doctors, but you have a family tattoo artist.
Yeah, exactly. It's kind of nice, isn't it? It kind of warms me from the inside. I told him, my dad is so down. He doesn't have any tattoos, but I'm like, Dad, I will take you in and sponsor the tattoo, like, vibe. Because it would look great on you. And he's down. My mom is not quite there yet, but I think she will be. I was like, just a tiny one, just for fun, so we can all have at least one. Like, that'd be fun. It's kind of a family thing. Families are doing it now. They're getting with the times.
Yeah. You should totally do a family portrait with your tattoos.
Yeah.
Just like...
Yeah.
Christmas card.
Just showing the... Yeah. Yeah, right. That's actually really funny.
You guys all get tramp stamps.
Yeah, I was just thinking the same thing.
Pointing.
I made a joke on set in the first few episodes that if we made it to season 5... I would get a Ricky tattoo.
So now it has to happen.
And I in like a really absurd place, like on my hip right here. Do you know what I mean? Like really bad.
I'm gonna be honest. I feel like if the show gets a second season, which I feel like it will, there will be fans getting Ricky tattoos. Ooh. I feel like that is a thing that will happen. I promise.
I hope so.
Yeah.
It's a great tattoo, actually, if you think about it.
It
looks really nice.
It's a very cool raccoon, yeah.
No, it's a really cool raccoon, and it's kind of like, it's fun. I literally said, I was like, I will get this. Like, everyone, I was making it, yeah. I'm kind of a ham, but I would actually do it, though. I
think it'd be a ham.
I know. Like, the tramp stamp may be a bit too much, but maybe, like, that really weird, awkward hip. Like, where
that's
you
like
can just kind of, like,
tattoo.
Yeah, exactly. Like, a really chick vibe tattoo. Yeah.
Guys, I don't know if you noticed, but he just pulled up his shirt a little bit for me.
And? Oh. Are you going to describe
I'm
what
swooning.
You see?
You can describe what you see.
I just wanted to let Shidget fan know. I thought Shidget fan would be really excited
Shidget
to hear that.
Shidget fan is Shidgeting.
2011.
Ooh, I love Shidget as a verb.
Yeah.
Did I just get Shidgeted?
Yeah.
That's so funny. Did I just get Shidgeted? Dun, dun, dun.
I think it's time we head into predictions.
We've kept you here so long.
Yeah.
And now, you're after
I love this show. I want to come back.
Yeah, totally.
I haven't left, but I want to come back. already.
So on the next episode, we see from the trailer that there is a college fair, and that Lucy wants to take a road trip with Noah. Elena, surprisingly, is not down. I'm surprised.
Right? It is surprising.
Will obviously doesn't like it either. And Elena catches Lucy in Noah's dorm, possibly because they're going on the road trip without her permission.
Yeah.
That is what the trailer shows us. So... you can't really give us a prediction, seeing as how you know what happens. So you can just make that face. Kylie, predict.
I predict that Elena is trying to make up for being a crappy mother in the past and trying to actually, like, be a mom now. And be like, no, I can say no to things because you're not 18 yet. And I don't want you to have an accidental baby that gets the same job as you in 20 years.
Nice. Nice. Were you a psychology major?
No,
that's a
not
nice little analysis right there. Yeah.
All right, Vivian.
Well, I am, you know, a total fan of Noah, and I think he's an innocent puppy, and I don't think anything's going to happen. I think everyone's going to set up for he's going to try and make a move, don't go for it. Okay. But I think he really just wants her to go to college, and that's it.
Wow.
Oh, that's very sweet.
Wow. That's so naive.
That's like a PSA.
Yeah, that is.
I think you were right on. I think Kylie's right on with her Elena theory. I predict we'll see some James. That's where I'm going.
That's all you care about. You just watch the show for James, Brady.
Yeah. Thank you so much for joining us. Why don't you tell the people who somehow don't know where they can find you on Twitter, Instagram, yeah, all that stuff.
If you know, I'm on all the socials. Yeah. My Twitter is the Shane Harper. I picked the a long time ago and someone else had it and now I can't change it. Anyway, so yeah, the Shane Harper is my Twitter. Facebook is just Facebook.com/ShaneHarper. And what music Instagram? Is going on
it's
right now?
It's our theme song.
Oh, got it, okay.
He's like, is this Price is Right?
Yeah, I was like, is it, huh? Drew?
Did you just dun-dun us?
There it so is. Good. Yeah. My Instagram is also the Shane Harper.
What? I'm sure fans don't know that already.
Yeah, if you don't know.
Yeah, where you been?
I feel like he copied me, because you can follow me on Twitter and Instagram at the Kylie Hodges.
What?
No way.
Tweet at me.
All right, Vivian, not
I'm going to tweet all you guys right
not
now.
The. Yeah. I'm probably one of the only not the's here. You can find me at _vivaciouslyv, vivaciouslyvivian.com, and poshpoispolish.com.
Oh, you started off with an underscore. That's a strong move. Like,
it is strong.
My Twitter is @_. You know, like, that's a real, like, aggressive way to, like...
Just, everyone needs to know the @_, because the other girl... That's not
you. Oh, wow.
All right. And of course, you can find me online at yael.tv. That's yael.tv. There you'll find information about the after shows I do here, including SVU and Constantine. Ooh. Also, you can find information about the stylings from Siren's Boudoir and on Twitter, Instagram, and all the rest at Yael Tygiel. That's yael.tygiel. Thanks so much. Stop turning it up.
From executive producers Maria Menounos, Kevin Undergaro, Phil Svitek, and the entire AfterBuzz TV staff, we would like to thank you for listening to the AfterBuzz TV network. To watch or listen to other after shows and post comments or questions, be sure to visit AfterBuzzTV.com. I'm Sir Richard Wentworth, and this has been a presentation of AfterBuzz TV.
Buzz you later.
The views expressed herein are those of the hosts only and do not necessarily reflect the views of AfterBuzz TV or its owners or principals.